everybody, and welcome back to my channel. This is my first voiceover, so bear with. So at the moment I was just cutting down my nails because I'm going to be taking off most of the acrylic, practically all of it, the acrylic, and applying gel. So I wanted to make sure I've got all of the acrylic off, because I'll be sculpting the gel. At the moment I am just using my e-file with a ceramic bit and removing my gel polish, and I'll also use it to take down some of my bulk. I got this bit from, I think it was from eBay. It was either eBay or AliExpress, but I think that one came from eBay. And that one is in a medium grit, if I remember rightly. I don't think it's the fine one. Well, it could be the fine one. I'll have to look that up and put it in the description box and see if I can find a link. I'll just let you continue watching me take down the bulk and the gel off my nails, and I'll be back when I get to the next stage. Now I've changed my bit to a small cone shaped bit. It's got quite a sharp point to it, so you have to be very careful when you're using this. I like to use it to clean underneath my nails, and it also, if any acrylic or gel gets underneath your nails, it's good for getting it off. But you have to be very, very careful. If you stab yourself with that, it's gonna hurt, it's gonna bleed. And obviously, when you've got the hypernicium underneath the nail, I've got really high hypernicium, so I have to be very careful. And that's a very delicate area, so if you're using it on yourself or on clients, be very, very aware of where you're putting that piece if you decide to do anything like this. I wouldn't advise you to do it if you don't have any training or experience with a e-file. It's something you've got to do when you're very comfortable and confident in using an e-file. I've been doing this for years, although I only recently qualified as a nail tech, but I have years of experience using it. So now I am just shaping my nails with a glass file, and I absolutely adore my glass file. Everyone should have one. It's perfect for using on natural nails, as unlike an emery board, which will disrupt your nail layers and split them, therefore making your nail weak, the glass file seals those edges, therefore making the natural nail stronger. Also, you can go back and forth in the seesaw motion with a glass file, and it will still just seal your edges. With a emery board, it's just going to damage your nails and make them weak. Never go seesawing or back and forth motion with an emery board on your natural nails. Not good, it will damage them. So now it's pushing back the cuticles. I'm doing this very gently. Bear in mind, this video is sped up quite a bit, so it looks like I'm going mental, but I'm not, I promise. I'm being very gentle, pushing back the epinicum without damaging it. So I've now changed my e-file bit to my cuticle remover, and I have that on a very low speed so that I can gently go around where my regrowth area is without damaging my epinicium, and just remove all of the old skin that has grown on the new growth area. Just get it all off. If you don't get it off, it will cause lifting. Whether you're applying acrylic or gel or hard gel, it will lift. So make sure you remove all of the skin, but be very gentle. There's no need to overfile that area. I'm now changing to a sanding bit on my e-file. I love my sanding bands. I think they're fabulous. A lot of people have issues with them, but I think that's a misconception that they're bad. It's the person that's using it that's bad if they're using it incorrectly. There's no reason to overfile. If you're using it on a low speed, very gently, you're not overfiling. It will not cause any more damage than if you had used a hand file. Simple as that, really. I'm just leveling out my surface, removing any lifted parts, and generally just roughing up the surface to enable better adhesion for my gel. And that's all it's needed for. I am loving my new 3-in-1 electric nail file with lamp and dust extractor. Works brilliantly. The lamp is really handy. The dust extractor obviously works really well. And the handpiece itself, oh my god, it's brilliant. It really is good. So much less vibration in the handpiece. It's ergonomically more comfortable to hold in the shape of it. It's slightly slimmer and smaller than my original piece, so it's also lighter. It makes it much more easier to hold. Love it. Brilliant. Can't say enough. I've got my old cuticle nippers out. I'm not cutting any live skin. I'm only cutting off bits that are hanging that will get in my way of my application. Dead skin only, not live tissue, okay? Be very careful with cuticle nippers, they can be dangerous. I'm just going to lift up the top to the dust extractor and show you that how easy it is to just brush down the nail dust off the fan part. Well, it's a cover over the fan part. Look how easy it is. That's it. And then you pull that little drawer out, empty it in the bin, you're done. Oh my gosh, so much easier. No bags, no dust bags. Love it.
So you've seen it working and works brilliantly. I just lift this up and I dusted all that down like this, because it was all the nail dust was here. I just dusted it down, and then now I can open this drawer and I'd be able to empty all of that out. I found a trick to get the fan working for when you're just hand filing without the drill going. So what you do is, if I turn the drill right the way, I'm using the foot pedal at the moment, but you can still do it with the hand control. Turn the drill, electric file, not drill, electric file. Turn the electric file right the way down, and the light turns off, the electric file stops, but the fan is still going. So that's pretty handy. You can still use the fan without having the electric fire going. Just a little tidbit for you in between getting my nails prepared. So I shall carry on, get some of the Silcare gel on this and see how it goes.
So here I am just applying my dehydrator. just to get make sure there's no oils left on the nail plate. And then I shall add my primer, which again, it all just helps the gel to adhere to the nail plate and help to prevent lifting. Fingers crossed it all works, because lifting's a pain in the butt, especially when you know, it lifts and you get it caught on your hair or something. It's really annoying. The products I've been using lately hasn't been lifting at all, which is really impressive. And I shall do an update on how the Silcare gel stays on after 2 or 3 weeks. I'll leave it on and see how it goes and give you a nice little update. Probably at the end of this video, actually, I'll add it on so that it's the full review. So I'm just adding some IBD bonder to my nails, just a very thin layer of this, and then I'll cure that in my I've got a sun UV lamp which cures UV and LED gels really quickly, so I'll just stick that under the lamp for 30 seconds. Now I'm going to apply my nail forms. Cool, nearly forgot what they were called then. And my hypernicums are really high, so I cut a piece out of the form to make it fit, because it actually hurts if you push a form up against your hypernicium and trying to make it fit. So I cut a piece out so that it fitted more comfortably. And the way I shape my forms, I shape them really quite tight so that I don't have to pinch, and these forms work really. I'll just continue adding my forms on and applying the thick builder gel. I was using the thick violet, or was it the thick clear? No, it was the thick clear I was using as my base, just to build a very thin layer and tip so that I can add my white and pink over the top after I take the forms off. But this is the way I like to do it. I like to do it with clear first to shape and form the nail. It's difficult because it's clear, so it's hard to tell where you've got it on the form sometimes. And you'll see later that this nail actually missed a bit, so when I tried to take the form off, it kind of ripped a bit. But it's easily fixed with just adding more gel. So yeah, I will just continue forming my nails, and I'll be back to let you know the next bit, I suppose. Oh no, I'm taking the forms off now. With that thick gel, yeah, you see I'm fighting with it now. With that thick gel, you can actually get away with doing your whole hand if you want to, because it doesn't move. So yeah, there I go. Adding some more gel onto that one, and I'll continue removing my forms. It's really good, that thick gel. Get away with, like I say, adding it all your fingers, and then curing, not a problem, doesn't move. Fabulous. I must say, I have fallen in love with Silcare gel. I don't see myself using any other gel now. So here I go with my pink. I'm using the cover pink, and it's just called cover. There are different pinks, there's medium and light and dark. This one's just called cover, and it's actually a really nice pink. It's really lovely to work with. The consistency is great, very easy to work with. So I'm just going to elongate my nail bed somewhat and cure them. I will flash cure, because this isn't a thick gel. It's just a normal consistency gel, so it doesn't stay where you put it for too long. I mean, it's not extremely runny, but obviously it's not an extra thick one, so you'll see that I'll turn my finger over to let gravity work and pull the gel towards the centre of the nail. And then I'll flash cure that for about 5 to 10 seconds, not long, and then get on with the next nail. So yeah, I shall come back when I do something else. As you can see, I'm just cleaning up my smile line and making it nice and neat. If you want a really crisp smile line, it's best to file after you've cured it before you're going with your white or other colour, because obviously you can do your tips different colours. But if you really want a crisp one, I suggest filing before going in with the other colour. I knew that I was going to be doing some nail art on my nails, so it didn't really matter that whether my nails were having a crisp smile line or not, therefore I didn't bother filing them. But if you're going to be having that smile line completely exposed, then I would suggest filing so that it's nice and crisp. But you'll see later, I do some nail art, so you don't really see my smile line much. This is the white, the Extremo. Again, very easy to work with, lovely consistency, goes on like a dream, love it. I'm really impressed with the Silcare gels, I must say. I'm very, very impressed with them, love it. What more can I say? Not a lot. So yeah, I'll just carry on putting my white on and you'll see. It's pretty It's pretty self-explanatory what I'm doing, so I'll leave you to it. This is the thick, clear violet that I'm adding on, and I've got a piece of fluff from my towel in there, and it's really bugging me, so I had to get that out. I hate it when that happens. But yeah, I'm just adding a nice layer of the thick violet, just to build up my nails. I could have made the white thicker, but I figured I'd just make it, build it up with the violet. Sorry, I'm saying a lot. And so, I've noticed I'm saying so, and I'm very sorry. I can't stop it. The gel, when you put your hand under the UV light or LED light or sun UV light, whatever lamp you have, it does warm up if it's really thick, but the heat spike isn't to the point where it burns and you have to take your hand out. But if it's very thick layer, because I did put some thick layers on with the cover and with the thick violet just to see how it felt, and it will warm up but not uncomfortably hot or uncomfortably warm, but you will feel it if it's a thick layer. So thumbs up on that. I can cope with it warming up and not burning, because burning is awful. That's the worst feeling. I'm faffing around with these three nails. This is the first time I've used the really, really thick gel, so it's taking a bit of getting used to. I will get better at it, I will. But yeah, this is the first time, apart from obviously adding the base layer on, I'm using a thick gel, so it's definitely a learning curve. cured my nails and wiped off the tacky layer. So now it's time for shaping and filing. Although my nails look absolutely horrendous right now, they will look fabulous after I've finished filing, I promise. I decided to just go in with my hand file because the gel's always softer than acrylic generally. So I thought I'd give it a try just with the hand file, see how I got on. And it filed like a dream just with my hand file. I didn't use my e-file at all, which is makes a change. I can't do it that too long with because my hands cramp up really badly. So if they cramp up, I would go straight to the e-file, but I sort of took little breaks and it was okay. It was nice and easy to file. Pleasant surprise. Brilliant. So I shall carry on with my filing and let you watch in peace. As I'm filing, I'm checking from every angle how the nail looks to make sure it's even on top, it's even from the barrel side, it's every which way you look at your nail and you make sure that it's even all the way around and that you've got a good slope to the cuticle area and another slope down to the free edge. Yeah, always check every angle, every aspect of your nail. I am a bit of a perfectionist, so I faff around way too much. I do take too long, but that's just me. Going in with some isopropyl alcohol to clean the dust off my nails and showing you how they look now after buffing and filing. Oh, there's the postman. Ooh, sounds like I got a package. Cool. Now I'm going in with my top coat. It's just an Elite 99 no wipe top coat, and I really love Elite 99 products. They're so reasonably priced and they work really well. I've got their matte top coat as well and it is brilliant. My nails stayed matte for 3 weeks and I was so impressed with that considering the price of it. Brilliant stuff. So I do like Elite 99 because it suits my budget and it works. It works, so I do recommend it, but if you don't like it, no, choice is yours. There are many, many companies around to buy products from. So I've cured all of that, and because it's tack free, I can go straight in with my oil, my cuticle oil. This one's my own blend. Love it. I did let the nails cool down for a good few seconds before I went in with the oil though, because obviously it will dull. Well, maybe it's not obvious to you, you may not know, but if you go in with cuticle oil too soon after taking your hand out of the lamp, it can dull the shine. So I have now completed my other hand. As you can see now, I've got the nails on and I'm doing my 3D acrylic rose. I'm using CJP acrylic. I used their crystal glass and mixed my own colours. I used some black mica, obviously, to make the black, and a little bit of white mica just to give it opacity. God, I forgot the word then. And the same with the gold. I used gold mica and just a touch of white mica just to give it a bit of opacity. And using a very, very small brush, nail art brush, it's just a cheap one from eBay or AliExpress. If you type in nail art brushes, I think it was in a set of three. They're very small brushes, very good, very cheap, which I love. I'm just patting away, shaping my petals. So I'm just using a very small bead. I'm using my acrylic really quite wet. A lot of people do it dry, but this is the way it works for me. So this is the way I do it. I'm just taking a very small bead of gold, and then I'm dipping it into the black, and then placing that bead on the nail, and then shaping it out, sort of pulling it into a C, and then patting it flat. You don't have to pat your petals as flat as I do. I do them this flat because I can't stand it if it gets... I've got very long hair, it's nearly down to my backside, so I don't like having things that will get caught in my hair, so I do it very, very flat so I get less opportunity of it getting caught in my hair. But you can definitely pull up the petals and make them much more 3D, which looks really lovely, but for practicalities of my own lifestyle, that doesn't work for me. Just take your time, there's no rush, and if your bead doesn't come out the way you like it, just push it off with your brush before it sets and put another one on. Yeah, they're not that difficult to do once you get the hang of it. Give it a go, you might surprise yourself. I apologise for going out of frame. It's when you're filming such a small area and you're concentrating on what you're doing, you sometimes forget to look up and make sure you're in frame. But I did look up and saw that I wasn't in frame and quickly moved my hand so that you guys could see what I was doing. So I'm just doing the centre of the flower, sort of stab the middle of the bead with the tip of my brush and swirl it around to just make another C type shape, but a more rounded one, and curl them around each other. If that makes any sense. Well, you've seen what I've done. Now I've got sort of in the shape of a dodgy backwards six or something. I'm just going to make some little leaves on now because I felt that I needed some. And they came out quite well. It's the same sort of system, just put a little bead on, double dip, put your little bead on and pattern shape into your desired shape. I'm using my cuticle pusher here just to make some lines, just to give the leaves a little bit of detail, which works really well. Now it's time for a little bit of nail art freehand drawing, and Again, I'm going in with Elite 99 gel polishes. This is a thermal cat's eye polish, and so it changes colour. You'll see on the tips will be what goes on the tip will be darker, and as it goes along the nail bed it will get lighter with the heat from my finger. Pretty cool. And it's got the cat's eye effect too. The other one that I showed you, the gold coloured one, actually glows in the dark, which is really cool. I completely forgot to take footage of that, so I'm sorry, I won't be able to show you the yellow one glowing in the dark, but at least you can see this thermal one changing colour on my nail bed to a lighter grey. Once I've finished doodling, because that is essentially what I'm doing, I'm making it up as I go along, I'll use the magnet that I have just to the cat's eye effect, and then I shall flash cure for 5 seconds to keep the gel from sliding around. There we go, I'm back. Now I'm going to go in with the gold kind of colour. It's a nice little shimmer to it. It's very subtle, and that's what I wanted. You could just basically see little trails of glitter, and like I said, it glows in the dark, which is pretty cool. I didn't want bright gold on, I just wanted just a subtle shimmer, which is what I got. I got the effect I wanted, and I think it matches my rose really well, actually. Very happy with that. Not happy with some of my doodles. They could have been better, but I'm not the greatest at freehand anyway, so I don't think they look awful. I think they came out okay. Pretty cool. So again, I'm just flash curing, and I'll carry on doodling away. I realise this video is rather long, so please feel free to skip through any parts that you find boring, but I know when I was starting out, I would have really appreciated if somebody had done videos like this for me to watch. So I've left a lot of what I do in the video for people who are just starting out and want to know the entire process that one goes through. So I'm hoping that I will help somebody and inspire them to start a nail journey of their own. I really enjoy doing nails, so if I can help somebody, that's the whole point of it. So yeah, please feel free, fast forward, skip, whatever, if it's too boring for you. Yay, all finished. This is the final result, so I'm adding my lovely cuticle oil, replace replenish those dry cuticles, put all my nourishment back on, and give it a good massage in. Lovely jubbly. I'm using that hand cream that I got from Silcare, and it's actually really nice. Love it. And there you go, all done. Now I'll leave you with my picture at the end. I hope you enjoyed watching. Bye.